Hey guys, my name is Alex. In this quick tip tutorial I'm going to explain to you how you can easily create seamless textures for, I don't know, walls and maybe some stones like marble. I got this idea for this tutorial after watching a great tutorial from Jamin Chollet from School of Game Design. That you can find under the description. I will post the link to that video, so check that out if you want the whole series explained. But I did a similar designs with just mere Photoshop filters and commands that don't require any hand drawing. So first of all, we're going to do this marble one. So I'm going to create a new layer, pressing Ctrl Shift and N, and you can name it if you want it. And then just leave black and white color and go to Filter, Render, Clouds. And then we're going to create another one. And we're going to press Ctrl F on the keyboard. This way we are going to do the same action, the same filter that was applied last. So we're going to go on Filter, Render and Different Clouds, and then just press Ctrl F a bunch of times so you get this kind of look, and then just put it on Multiply and go here under Adjustments. If you don't have it, you have to go on the window and click on Adjustments, and pressing Alt on the keyboard and pressing here on Levels, it's going to open a new window, which it's going to ask if you want to use this filter on the previous layer. You just click here and click OK. This way we're going to affect only the layer that is beneath this filter. So we're going to decrease blacks a little bit, maybe something like this. Just play around with the settings under Levels and you get the idea what you can do with it. If you duplicate it by just selecting them, holding Shift and then dragging it down to the Create New Layer, and then just select this layer and go to Screen, you get a totally different look. So as said, as you can see here, the whites are punching out now. Get this kind of look. So sometimes I just double click on the layer and this window pops up, and then just holding Alt on the keyboard and pressing, clicking on the, this triangle, and then just push it to the right, you're going to get rid of the blacks. And if you do the same on the holding Alt and click and dragging the whites, you're going to get rid of the whites. So just play around to get some random effect, and let's say this is pretty much what we want, and we can apply a color to this design. So just go under Adjustments, and you have to be on the layer that is not a filter, and we just go Hue Saturation, and we're going to put it up. And we don't want it to affect only this one, so we're going to go place the cursor between these layers holding Alt, so the cursor changes, and then just click it. Double click on the Hue Saturation and click on Colorize, and just select the color that you would like your marble to look like. Let's say a little bit bluish, washed out color. And then just go up to the top layer and press Ctrl Alt Shift and E on the keyboard. That's Control, Shift, Alt and E. This will merge all the layers that are visible, but will leave them still to make some changes, so you can still go back and do some different design. But what I want to show here is go on the filter and other and offset, and because we started with the with a document of size 1024 by 1024, we just offset it by the half of this value. And because it's a seamless texture, we don't get any lines that would apply that it's going to cause problems when applying this texture to your model in 3ds Max Maya or something similar. So this was the trick, because after applying render clouds or different clouds, the texture will be seamless at default. So this is really great. I didn't know that before. I watched the Jamin Schule's tutorial, so thanks for that. And after playing around with settings that I just shown, like levels, and you can play around with brightness and contrast to get some different results. You can create a bunch of different seamless textures that can be used for your games or some similar designs. Here I just use the same techniques, but just apply a different filters. So let me just quickly show how I did this one. I'm just going to filter and again render clouds for the base, and I'm going to duplicate it holding Ctrl J on the keyboard and pressing Ctrl F again to create a different one. And then just go to filter, and I think it was pixelate and mezzotint. And here you can select the different kind of effects. I used fine dots, and just go to screen or multiply. Let's use screen, and then just turn it down a little bit, and you get this grainy look. And it's all seamless. Even if we, even after we apply this grainy looking filter, it's still seamless. And we're going to create another one. So just render clouds, and this time we're going to go to filter and sketch and note paper, and this window will pop up. It's pretty large. I'm going to scale it down so you can see what I'm doing, and you just play around with the settings here to get a different kind of look, and then when you are happy with it, just click OK. And then again, go to multiply and maybe screen. No, multiply is better. And you can get a picture. This could be a wall that is pretty decayed or something similar. And you just turn down the opacity a little bit to get some different results. And again, if you hold Control, Shift, Alt, and E, all the visible will be merge together in a new layer. And if we go to filter, other, and offset it, as you can see, it's seamless. You don't have any lines that would apply that you will bump into trouble. So this is pretty much it for this tutorial, how to create seamless textures with filters in Photoshop. So subscribe to my channel, check out the rest of the videos, and till next time, bye!